Welcome back to Angel Wings for the 8th installment. I am very excited. I'm very ready to tear up and cry. I got my water with me, and I'm ready to break down into tears. But anyways, well, students, you finally made it. The last day of school is here, and not a moment too soon. I need a vacation and a cocktail. You're not gonna miss us? Oh, of course I will, you silly brats, just not as much as I miss my freedom. I mean, don't forget about me, and make sure you all make it to the big concert tomorrow. Our very own Yuzhong will be performing. Students begin milling out of the classroom, while others linger in the classroom, savoring the last few moments of the semester. I can't believe you convinced her to play. That's amazing. It wasn't easy, that's for sure. What, did you have some heartfelt confession at sunrise like in a drama, or at sunset like in a drama? Did you embrace tenderly in the breath of twilight? Yuri? What are you two talking about? Nothing, see you at home. Yay, summer. She skips out of the room with the energy of a child on a sugar high. Yuzhong chuckles awkwardly. Well, I guess I should stick around a little longer and practice for tomorrow. I could use some company, if you want to, I guess. I'd love to. We laid in the grass all evening, hand in hand, just watching the clouds pass by. Eventually, the clouds turned to stars. Tomorrow's the big day. There's no better way to prepare than to relax, something I don't think Yuzhong has had the opportunity to do in a long time. Are you nervous? About tomorrow, or nervous about being here with you? You know which one I meant, dummy. She giggles. Yeah, I'm a little nervous. Tomorrow could be the last day of my music career, at least being able to follow it seriously. You're gonna do great. She sits up and continues to look up at the stars, her hand in mine. My mom loved music so much. She'd always sing, hum, or play for us before we could even talk. She taught me how to play before I was even potty trained. She laughs for a moment, as if to hide her sorrow. It's funny. I feel like I know she's watching over me, even now, cheering me on. She never stopped believing in me, or Yuri. And even though she's gone, I know that nothing has changed. She looks down at me and smiles. No matter what happens tomorrow, I'm glad I met you. This never would have happened without you, Andre. Besides, I can't think of anything else I would do outside of music. I don't even know what a square root is. Wait, seriously? Alright, that was good. Oh, here we go. Holy shit, this is insane looking. Look at this fucking place. Yuzhong, Yuri, and I wait in the wings of the ornate concert hall, temporary home to thousands of well-dressed spectators observing the best and brightest talent that Mood Academy has on display. The performers are dressed to the nines as well, each wearing a fresh tuxedo or a fashionable evening dress. Yuzhong dons a slim black ensemble, while Yuri and I are woefully underdressed. The professor hobbles towards us, clearly strained by the hours of standing in stiletto heels all evening thus far. You're on deck, Yuzhong, darling. Ready for your moment in the limelight? Yuzhong nods, clearly going over the notes and keys in her head. Lovely. I'll give the audience a brief intro after this piece wraps up, and then it's all you. Yuzhong is the last one for the night, according to the lineup. She wrings her hands in an attempt to stop them from shaking. Oh, I can see Dad from here. Yuzhong's hands begin to shake once more at the mere mention of her father, eyes firmly planted on the floor. Please, you need to grab her hand. I reach out and grab her hand. She flashes me a brief look of surprise before smiling weakly. Thanks. She takes a deep breath and seems to relax a little, a fraction of the insurmountable tension escaping her body. Don't worry, you're gonna do great. Alright, we're gonna hold off for a minute because I know I've been skipping a lot of music, so we're gonna see if this one plays through. Yuzhong takes a deep breath and braces herself. The professor walks out to the stage, microphone in hand. Wow, that was quite a performance. Well done by another of our top students. Last for tonight, but certainly not least, is our supremely talented Yi Zhong. I've had the fortune of working directly with her for the past year. She's so experienced that sometimes I think she should be teaching me. The audience chuckles. Yi Zhong walks onto the stage on cue. Hey, Yuri, which one is your dad? Oh, the one in the blue suit over there, the serious-looking guy with the glasses. Yi Zhong will be performing The Fox's Secret, one of the more complex technical pieces in our collection. Enjoy! Yi Zhong delicately seats herself at the grand piano, adjusting everything to her preferred specifications. Her father watches intently, arms crossed. She looks over at me one last time, the bright white stage lights bathing her in an angelic glow. I smile at her because I know she's going to blow everyone away. Oh, wow. This isn't the song she was supposed to play. Instead, it's her mother's song. God, she is so goddamn pretty. But this time, it feels different somehow. As if all the pain she's felt over the years is being channeled through her fingertips. She breathes a new life into the song I've heard many times before. God, this soundtrack is insane. The art is amazing. I don't know if I've praised this game and this... It's not even a game, it's an interactive novel, but it is still great. More than sadness or pain, it makes me feel... hope. I can only watch in awe as Yi Zhong pours her soul into this tribute in front of not only thousands of people. The crowd stands in a rousing ovation as Yi Zhong bows gracefully, looking straight at her father through the blinding light. After moments of silence, her father reluctantly begins to applaud as well. I look over at Yuri, tears rolling down her cheeks as she cries into her sleeve. Wow, an amazing and heartfelt improvisation from our one and only Yi Zhong. Thank you all for coming tonight. Yi Zhong steps backstage, smiling with tears welling in her eyes as Yuri leaps to her, wrapping her in a tight embrace. I can't believe you did that. Yuri begins bawling into Yi Zhong's shoulder as Yi Zhong delicately wipes away her own tears, looking up at me with a relieved smile. I just hope it was enough. Yuri steps back, sniffling and wiping her nose with her sleeves. Well, you better go talk to Dad. I'll help clean up. Thanks, Yuri. Oh, boy. We emerge from the concert hall's cavernous back entrance. Yi Zhong's father stands out with his passenger car door open. Oh, this is what he looks like. Oh, wow. I didn't think we would get to see what he looks like. His expression appears grim and joyless, even in the face of the most emotional performance of the night. We're leaving now, Yi Zhong. Dad, why so soon? What? I don't know what you were trying to do with that stunt, but nothing has changed. What do you mean? I just thought, the school year's over, you're done here, you're done with chasing music over your own health. Rendered speechless, a look of confusion and dismay covers Yi Zhong's face. Sir, try to understand. He flashes me a glare sharp enough to cut glass before he interrupts me. I don't know what you've been trying to do here, but our family matters are truly none of your concern. Mr. Seo is his name. So Yi Zhong Seo. Very cool. But Dad, this is what I want to do. She stands straight, fists clenched at her sides. I want to stay here, with my music, with Yuri, with Andre. Clearly taken aback by Yi Zhong's sudden display of willpower, her father's expression turns to one of anger. Oh, don't you fucking dare, sir. The answer is no, and that's not going to change. We're going back to the house so you can pack your things. I'm flying you out first thing in the morning. He grabs her forcefully by the arm and wrestles her into the car, despite her struggling to break free. No. Dad, stop. She looks back at me, tears rolling down her face once again. I don't want this to be goodbye. The car begins to pull away. No. No. What was the point of all this? I just want to know the reason for all this. To find love, to fix something in my life, to teach me some kind of lesson. This all could have been avoided. Wait, day 42? Are you going to say something? Who? I just wanted a family. Kai? What? A family that loved each other, stuck together, no matter how hard things got. A real family who accepted each other, loved each other unconditionally. Something that I never had. Something that I could never have. But look at what happened. I know you've been hurt. I know you've felt lost. So has Yejong. I know that now I've lost the closest thing I've ever had to a family. For the others, there are other realities, other ways where they've found their happiness. Everyone has someone to love, and they have someone who loves them. Andre, you and I have that one thing in common. There's no one for either of us, no other reality where we find what we're looking for. I'm not finding my way out of that phone job. I don't have any family to support me. The closest thing I have to friends are the people who come and go in this house. And you, let's face it, you were doomed to spend the rest of your days rotting in apathy with nobody to love and nobody to love you. I know you have a family. You had friends. You rejected them because, in the end, you felt like you weren't deserving of their trust, their affections. We're more alike than you want to believe. I've watched everything you've done since day one, your trials and tribulations. Everything you did to grow as a person, and to grow closer to the impossibility of finding true love. In the end, it still feels impossible, doesn't it? But you inspired me. That's why after all this, losing the false family I tried so hard to create, you're still the one I need, Andre. You're the only one. So forget all of this. Stay with me. It's true. I'm tired of fighting, tired of being hurt. But after all I've been through, picking myself up from nothing, meeting amazing people, and finally breaking free from the cycle of apathy and self-hatred, it proves that anything is possible. The reality where nobody loves me? That's not the reality I live in anymore. I finally found someone that I truly care for, to whom I can truly say, I love you. These feelings are real. I know they are. I ran as quickly as my body would carry me. I chased after a dream that mere weeks ago seemed like a distant impossibility, but in the end, I couldn't run fast enough. Yuzhong, one of the most talented, brightest, and kindest people I've ever met. But behind all of her accolades and achievements, behind that smile, she always seemed so sad. And a little lonely. A girl that seemed like she never needed anyone, the kind that would never ask for help. It wasn't my place to get involved, and now she's gone. But I know that my feelings were real. Even though we never got our happy ending, I'll always cherish the memories we shared. Yuzhong. Oh my god.
We did it.
Wow. That was... First off, once again, soundtrack is amazing, but, This is awesome. Sound source from freesound.com. I don't even care. That was amazing. I have never been. Wow. I don't know if the song is copyrighted, and God, I hope it's not, but I do not care. This song is unbelievable. This is amazing. I knew it. I knew something was gonna happen. That's how life goes. Wow. I lost Nuri, but you know what? She had it coming when she decided to do that. I don't want to get my heart broken twice, so this might actually be the shortest episode. Wow. I have to say, I was not expecting that sad of an ending. But that's it. That's Angel Wings the first run wrapped up. Nah, there's got to be more to it. There's no way that they end a run like that. There's no way. There's no way. Well, what do you? Evening gown and the classic Kai. New game plus is now unlocked. What the heck is a new game plus? Well, guys, so after going into it for a minute, I thought about it. And I don't think I can take another run of this, because I remembered the downside is they're working on some text to speed things up, but yeah, I think we're going to wait to do that, because there's a lot to it, and I'm just going to wait for that, and once I know that, I will be going back. I will be trying to go 100% through this, because a part of me actually wants to do Nuri's story, because I really want to know, would she have cheated on us? Would we have not gotten her choice of affection? But we're gonna have to see what happens. Either way, I hope y'all enjoyed this little series. I apologize for this episode being so short, but I will see you all next time. Peace to the out.